I woke up and found that my Google Ads account had been suspended, and I had no idea why. And in this video, I'm going to share what happened, all the different ways that I tried to fix my Google Ads account. And these are all the common ways that if your Google account is suspended, these normally should work, but none of these ways worked for me. And finally, at the end of the video, I'm going to share with you what I did that actually fixed my Google Ads suspended account and made it so that I could start running Google Ads again. And if your Google Ads account has been suspended, this is the perfect video for you because I've watched every single video out there on Google Ads and getting over suspensions, and none of those other videos helped, but I'm going to share with you what actually got my Google Ads account fixed. So hopefully you can get your Google Ads account fixed as well. And smash the like button because I went through a lot of stress working on my Google Ads account, learning all these different things that I'm going to share with you in this video. And I've personally been running Google Ads for over 8 years. I've spent hundreds of thousands of dollars on Google Ads, and this is the first time that my Google Ads account has ever been suspended. So this is not necessarily a common thing, but when it does happen to you, it's very frustrating. And I've started multiple different Google Ads accounts for multiple different businesses, and sometimes this can be a problem. If Google Ads sees that you're starting lots of different Google Ads accounts, they may flag you and they may say that you're doing something suspicious. In my case, the error that I got was the circumventing systems policy error, which is one of the most frustrating errors because there's lots of different reasons why you might get this error. And of course, Google Ads doesn't tell you which one of the possible issues that your account is actually having. Now, the first thing when you get your Google Ads account suspended, you're gonna wanna do is probably go appeal it, write up some reason why, and submit that appeal. But I recommend do not do that. Wait until you watch this entire video before you submit an appeal. And specifically, always try to figure out what the issue is that Google is complaining about and try to fix that issue before you submit an appeal. Because if you submit an appeal without fixing the issue, that might make it so that the next time you submit an appeal, they don't even look at your appeal. So I tried lots of different things to try to fix the issue with my Google Ads account. The first thing I did was I actually read that you need a privacy policy. This is something that Google doesn't really make super obvious to you, but you need a privacy policy on the landing page that you're sending people to from your Google Ads. So make sure you add a privacy policy, terms and conditions, all that different kind of legal stuff. Make sure you add that. Another common issue that you might find is that your website has been hacked. Make sure that your website has not been hacked, because sometimes if there's some kind of malware or some kind of issue with the main landing page, then this could create a flag for Google system. And obviously they don't want you sending traffic to a website that has been hacked. You also want to make sure you're not selling anything that's illegal or frowned upon. No counterfeit goods, no selling any kind of prescription drugs or anything that Google might think is a prescription drug. Another extremely common reason why you might get suspended from Google Ads is if you have repeat policy violations. And this is an issue that I had on my account, but it wasn't the main reason that my account got suspended. You're not allowed to use a trademarked business name in your ad copy, but on this channel, I talk about Amazon and selling on Amazon a lot. But I did have repeat times where I used the word Amazon in my copy and they would immediately flag me and I'd immediately fix it. But this was one of the reasons why I thought maybe my account had been suspended, but it wasn't the real reason why. Now, before I share the reason why my account was suspended, some other really common issues why your account might get suspended is any kind of payment issues. Make sure that you do not abuse the coupon code system. And if you don't know, Google often gives out some credit to new Google Ads accounts. And what people will do is they'll start an account, use that credit, go start another account, use another new credit, and just keep doing this to get free money. But if Google catches you, they're gonna ban you from ever being able to use Google Ads, and it's not worth doing this. There can also be issues with unpaid balances where you charge a bunch of money to your account, but then you cancel your credit card. Or another example of this is where you do chargebacks. Google charges you $500 for running their ads, and then you call the credit card company and tell them, you know what, I didn't spend that money with Google. Let's charge back that money. Don't do this. It's not worth it in the long run. And I went down this list and I looked at all the different common reasons why people get suspended with Google Ads. And I tried fixing all of them, and I would submit an appeal and it wouldn't work. So I'd try something else again and I'd submit an appeal and it wouldn't work. And finally, I ended up contacting an expert. So I contacted John at stubgroup.com. I'll put a link down below to their website, and they were finally able to help me. And so here's one of my big tips is if you're trying all these different things and it's not working, go contact a professional. And I contacted a bunch of different websites that do this professionally, and John and the stubgroup.com are the only people that were able to help me. A lot of times they might even give you a free overview of what might be going wrong with your Google Ads account, and they'll see whether or not they can help you. They don't work with everybody and they are a little bit pricey. So keep that in mind, that if you're looking to fix your Google Ads account, are you willing to spend a decent amount of money to get this fixed? It's not a free service. But John ended up looking at my Google Ads, ended up looking at my website, and he told me, did a complete screen recording saying, hey, these are all the different things you need to fix. And what was going wrong with my website was something that I did not even realize. So first off, the privacy policy thing was a really big thing. On top of that, I was sending traffic to a website without a complete URL. It was a lead page URL. And specifically, one of the big issues was the website was only really collecting an email. It wasn't really providing that much value. Then on top of that, and I think this personally was probably the really big thing, is when people would put in their email, I would actually direct them to a different website. So this is why I think I got the circumventing the system's policy, because I was taking them from the landing page website to a completely different website. And I think this triggered something in Google saying, hey, you're sending them to some other website. You're cloaking this other website and hiding it from us, Google. So immediately they just flagged that. Even though the website I was taking them to was a pretty okay website, there was nothing majorly wrong with it. In Google's mind, it was taking them from one website to another website, which was the issue. Now, John did say that the website I was taking them to, that maybe I should change some of the wording, because it's a sales website. So obviously some of the things were worded relatively strongly. So what I ended up doing was creating a different landing page just for people coming from Google Ads. And after I made all these fixes, John went ahead and submitted another appeal, and like magic, everything was fixed. So I recommend trying to fix your Google Ads account on your own at first. And if you absolutely cannot get it fixed, it might be worth it to hire an expert. I'll put a link down below to the stubgroup.com, which is the website that I use to be able to fix my Google Ads suspended account. Thanks for watching.